director can launch objects up to 20 feet.
Bullshit. We've never recorded any distance over 5.
Obviously, you never read the P6 data.
So I just read this. Welcome to the Ranger Field Training Course. The course must be completed in the specified amount of time. When you're ready to start, press the button. Is that all, or?
I always did love obstacle courses.
Get ready, Ranger. Course starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Seconds remaining. Seconds remaining. 15 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Course failed. Try again, Ranger. Ready, Ranger. Course starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. 45 seconds remaining. 30 seconds remaining. 15 seconds remaining. Failed. complete. Try again, Ranger.
Come on!
Guessing this isn't usually part of the course. It's protecting itself. Time to have a shield. She's in trouble. I need to reach her.
Thank you.
The astral plane. Similar to an iceberg, what you see is not what you always get. Regardless, this place is vitally important to the Bureau. Most information on the astral plane is classified, but we can talk in broad strokes, keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them no justice. Now, the white non-space, the ever-present inverted black pyramid. The board, all linked, intrinsically tied to the oldest house, tied to the director, the process of choosing a director, tied to all objects of power in terms of who controls them. Yes. Information on the astral plane is classified, but we can talk in broad strokes, keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them no justice. Now, the white... non-space, the ever-present inverted black pyramid. The board, all linked. Intrinsically tied to the oldest house, tied to the director. Choosing a director, tied to all objects of power. Yes. Thank you.
An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions. Apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement, native species, always in the distance, and yet contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astronauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fugue, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
Thank you.
Bureau doing with that thing?
Someone answer, dammit! We need backup down here!
Marshall, are you still there?
Shit. We're so close. We need to hurry.
Thank you.
group. All agents are ordered to converge here.
An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place.
your name for the record. Paul Warren, astronaut, first class. And you are aware that exposure to the astral plane can result in death, disability, personal injury, corporeal entangling, cognitive collapse, loss of ego, and partial to full dementia?
Yeah. I am.
And you acknowledge that your use of the astral conduit, aka the X-ray light box, is purely voluntary?
Yes, I do.
Perfect. Your suit is good?
Yeah.
Okay, you're all set. Open the door for Mr. Warren, please.
Brains were fried when I took over the object.
Good.